You are the supreme personality of Godhead, the origin and the supreme Lord of all living entities. You have arisen to disseminate the rays of the sun in order to dissipate the darkness of ignorance of the universe.
Jādhyam bhagavān puṁśāṁ īśvara vai mamān kila lokasya tamasā andasya chakṣu sūrya ibodhita. So, there is the Supreme Person, Bhagavān. Originally, it is very common sense, just like we require a leader to organize some business, some nationality, any group of organization. It requires a leader. Without leader, you cannot organize anything. Nobody has got any such experience that without direction, without leader, anything has sprung up automatically by nature. The foolish philosophers say like that the whole cosmic manifestation has come out of a chunk. They say like that. Rascals say like that. There was a chunk. And where from this chunk came? No, that is not fact. Fact is that there must be a good brain behind all these organizations, this cosmic manifestation. There must be a leader. That is the information we get from Vedas. Nitya nityana chetana chetanana. Nitya, we living entities, we are nitya. Na hannate hannamane sarire. We do not die. Na jayate naam yate va. Neither we take birth or we die. We simply change the body. Vāsāṁsi jinnāni yathā vihāya. As old garments, old shirts and coats, we change. Similarly, when this body becomes old enough, not to be used, we change to another body. Tathā dehāntara prāpti. This is real knowledge. So we are eternal. And God is also eternal. In that way we are the same quality. God is eternal, we are also eternal. God is cognizant, chetan, avijna, we are also chetan. We are not dull matter. So, what is the difference between God and me? The difference is great, we are small. He is Vibhu, we are Anu. He is all-pervading. We are very small. He is infinite. We are infinite Sima. That is the difference. So nitya nityanam chetana chetananam. That is the basic information. So you apply your reason, arguments. As you find here, you are more intelligent than me, somebody else more intelligent than you, others more intelligent than he. In this way, if you analyze, there is not all of us not on the same level. One is more intelligent, one is less intelligent. Similarly, you go on analyzing one after another, throughout the whole universe. Then you come to the demigods, and the most important demigod is Lord Brahma. So, he is the original creature within this universe. So he is also not enough intelligent. You'll have to find out a person more intelligent than him. So that is, we get information, just like Brahma, he was alone in the beginning. So where from he got knowledge? There was nobody else. So Shastra says, yes, he got knowledge, tene brahma rida adikavaye. He got knowledge from Krishna, brahma haite chatunmukh. So there must be some leader. In order to get knowledge, we have to find out some leader. And actually by our experience, whatever we doing, just like we got independence. So there was a leader, Mahatma Gandhi. He led the country, then you came to your national consciousness and you combined together and the Britishers went ahead. The opinion was against them. So there must be leader. That leader is a person. That leader cannot be an imperson. No, that is not possible. I think there was a news in the newspaper, Free Press Journal, that the faith in personal God is diminishing. That means they are becoming more foolish. The faith in personal God is diminishing, percentage diminishing. That means people are becoming more and more foolish. That is natural. Is it Kali Yuga? Manda samanda matayo manda bhagya jubadhita. The more this age of Kali will increase, people will diminish in their bodily strength, in their memory, in their mercifulness, in so many ways, eight kinds of diminishing, decreasing. We find even in Western countries, the present generation, they are not as strong as their father or grandfather. Bodily strength increases. Memory is decreasing. There is no mercifulness. Now, at the present moment, if somebody is being killed and you are passing, nobody takes care, let him be killed. Because daya, mercifulness is diminishing. The duration of life diminishing. The bodily states are diminishing. The memory diminishing. Everything is diminishing. So, because we are diminishing in everything, therefore our God consciousness is diminishing also. Therefore the news was that God, personal God conception is diminishing. That is natural. Mudha, that is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, that one who does not accept the personal God, he is described in the Bhagavad Gita, Mura. Namang duskitinam Mura parpadante naradhama. Maya abhrita jnana asuri bhava masrita. These classes are men. As soon as you find somebody godless, he does not know what is God, what is meaning of God, or he does not surrender to God, he does not know what is God, where is the question of surrender. Then we have got a test you, statement of Krishna, then what class of man he is. If he does not believe in God, he does not know what is God, what is our relationship with God, then what class of man he is. So we have got this test of Bhagavad Gita. What is that? Duskriti no. And always engaged in sinful activities. Therefore he does not. Duskriti no. And what other qualification? Mura. Ass. Rascal. Namang duskitin lam mura prabhadante naradhama. Naradhama means the lowest of the mankind. Why lowest? Because the human life is meant for understanding God and he does not know. Therefore he is lowest of the mankind. Naradhama. Why it is so? There are so many university degrees, MA, PhD, DSc and so on, delete. Still, he does not know. He still is murha. Bhagavad Gita says, yes, maya purita jnana. The knowledge he has achieved that has been taken away by maya. He is superficially, simply degree holder. His actual knowledge is taken away. So therefore, maya aparita jnana. Why this has happened? Asuri bhavam asrita. Because he defies. What is God? I am God. You are all God. Why you are searching God? There are so many gods loitering in the street. Take care of them. So, this is not advancement of civilization. Because such kind of civilization is increasing, therefore in the paper we find that faith in personal God is decreasing. But God is person. Here it is said. What is that? Ja adya bhagavan. Originally bhagavan. Adya means origin. There are three conceptions of absolute truth. What is that? That is stated in the Bhagavad. Vadanti tat tatta vidas tatyam jad jnanam advayam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaniti sabdati. The absolute truth, tatta. Tatta means the truth, original. Tattamasi. That tattam is Bhagavan. And the absolute truth is understood in three features, three angles of vision. The first is Brahma, impersonal Brahma. The second is localized Paramatma. And the ultimate is the Supreme Personality of God. So Brahma realization is not complete realization of the absolute truth. Neither Paramatma realization is absolute or the complete understanding of the absolute truth. When you realize Bhagavan, then you understand what is Paramatma, what is Brahma, and what is Absolute Truth. Jadgyatya, jasmini vijnate sarvam idam vijnatam bhavanti. That is the Vedic instruction. If you understand Bhagavan, then you understand Paramatma, you can understand Brahmans. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddeshe arjuna tishthati brahman sarvabhutani jantraru rani maya. This is Paramatma. Ekangshina sthito jagat. That is one portion, partial understanding of the Absolute Truth. So far Brahma is concerned, that is stated in Bhagavad Gita, brahmano aham pratishtha. I am the origin of Brahma effulgence. Amritasya, shashvatasya, cha. This is the statement. And so far he is concerned, Krishna matta parataram nanya kinchijasti dhananya. This is understanding of Bhagavad Gita. So far he is concerned, he says, there is no more superior truth than me. matta parataram nanna. Kinchi jasti dhananjaya. So everything is resting on Krishna. That is to be understood. That is the Vedanta understanding. Janmadasya jataha. Everything includes Paramatma and Brahma and what to speak of other demigods. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Aham sarvasya prabhava. This is the truth. Everyone reads Bhagavad Gita, takes Bhagavad Gita and takes photograph. I am very good scholar of Bhagavad Gita. But he does not know what is Krishna. Let's see. I know everything except Krishna. This is my knowledge. No. If you understand Krishna, jasmin vijñāte sarvamedam vijñātam bhavanti, then you understand everything. Just like if you understand what is 100,000 rupees, then you can understand automatically what is 10 rupees and what is 50 rupees. So everything is within that, the absolute truth. Now Devahuti has understood. Therefore she says, Ja Adya Bhagavan. My dear son, Kapil Dev, I know that you are the same Supreme Person, Bhagavan. And Bhagavan is Adyam. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Vasudev is Adyam. Arjun, when he understood Bhagavad Gita, he accepted Krishna as one. Parabrahma, Paramadhama, Pavitram, Paramam, Bhavan, Purusham, Adyam. He was the Supreme Person, original person. But Brahma says, Govindam, Adipurusham, Tamaham, Bhajami. He says, I worship the original person. Govinda. Govindam Adipurusham. Everywhere you'll find, and the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, says also, Matta Parataram Nanna. Govindam Adipurusham. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha. Anadi. Adi. He has no Adi. Somebody will say, why not? Krishna is born of Vasudeva, Vasudeva is his father. That is his acceptance, a devotee as father. There are dealings of the devotee and the Bhagavan in different ways. Santa, Dasa, Sakya, Vatsala, Madhurya, we can have relation. We have that relation. Now it is covered. We can revive it again. Simply appreciation of the Supreme, that is called Santarasa. When one appreciates fully, then he wants to give some service. That is called Dasa. And giving service, when one becomes more intimate, then he becomes friend. And that is called Sokha. Then, more advanced, the devotee wants to give service to Krishna as father. Father, mother means to give service to the son from the very beginning. Even as a sweeper, all taking care. So this is service. The Christian conception of God as father is not so perfect, because if we conceive God as father and mother, then the policy is to take from him. Because everyone wants to take from the father. Father, give me that. Mother, give me that. But this philosophy, that to accept the Supreme Lord as son, that is means to give service. Yashoda Mai, she has gotten Krishna as her son, See, all his answers. Krishna may not be in danger. Krishna is crawling. Some animal may not attack. He may not fall down in the water. He may not touch fire. All his anxiety. Giving protection to Krishna. Krishna is giving protection to the whole universe. And Jasodama is giving protection to Krishna. This is conception of philosophy, Vaishnava philosophy. She is anxious has to give protection. Krishna was taken away by the, what is that, Osu? Tinavat, yes. Now, Krishna was taken, and Mother Jasoda became mad, my son has been taken. Krishna became so heavy that the Asura could not stay in the sky, and he fell from a deep, distant place and immediately died. And Jasoda Mai saw that God has saved my Krishna. Jasoda Mai saw, God has saved. He began to thank some other god, some devota, because she knows Krishna is my son. She does not know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. If he thinks that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then the relationship between mother and son will be destroyed.